Next thing is Reuben, our butcher, is going to go through the preparation of the meat. In this case, it's a Scotch fillet.
We're here today, we're just going to talk about what we're going to be cooking on the Kamado. And what we've chosen is a 3 kilo piece of quality Mark New Zealand Scotch fillet. Taking it out about an hour before we're going to cook to bring it up to room temperature, because we want it to, the meat to be relaxed, and we're going to slowly bring up the temperature. This is going to take about 2 hours to cook, and then we're going to rest it for a bit, and then we're going to give it some hard and fast, not in the flame, so it doesn't get all the carcinogenic crusts on it. You could easily feed probably 15 people on it. If you slice it nice and thin, so that's allowing 200 grams per person. One of the first things is that when I'm sort of organising it, I will make sure I've cleaned off all the surfaces and everything's all nice and clean, and we're not doing any veg prep. So we're just going to be having all the meat here, cut the sort of chain off your meat, and having this sort of bit of fat is going to protect the meat, and that's going to stop it from drying out. If you've got any leftover from where the butchers have taken it off the bone, that gristle there, it won't break down. So that's sort of what we just sort of want to remove.
We don't want to be over-salting meat for too long, but for about sort of 45 minutes to an hour, I think it's perfectly fine. Just while that temperature of the meat comes up from the fridge temperature into a room temperature. So we are going to use a little bit of just yellow mustard. Yellow mustard has got a little bit of vinegar in it. Vinegar on the meat helps the rub not only stick to it, but also transfers some of that flavour down through the meat. You will not taste the mustard once this is finished. What this does, it does act as a binder, but it also helps to build a bark, and the bark is where the flavour is. We've got this bull dust here that we created. It's just salt, pepper, garlic, paprika, and there's a few other little secrets in there. So we're just going to go ahead and give it a little season. Now, we don't want to overpower the meat. Okay. On the other side. Salt is quite important for smoking, because what salt does is it penetrates into the meat and it opens up those pores. And when the pores are open, this meat will accept the smoke and give us that lovely smoky flavour. So that's all we're going to do, just a light little dusting. The barbecue's just about up to temperature. We'll let that bad boy sit for another half an hour. As Reuben said, it's good to get the temperature of the meat to room temperature, so we're not shocking the meat, because shocking the meat makes it tense up.